being disciplined, stuff like this. And this type of players, they don't really do well in leagues. You
No.
can't really compare. You can't say, you know, a player that's more skilled is better than a player that's more disciplined. You know, you can't really compare those players, but it's just the way it is. So yeah, that's why I say that. Coming back to this game, so they have Bamboo, W33, Always Wanna Fly, Dumpster Player is Arise, Kill Me is Sexy Bamboo, Shashlo is Shashlo, obviously, True Believer is Always Wanna Fly, and they have Mag is the Quap, they have Kuroki, Dire, that is, S4, who's there as well? Crit, and 1-47. Yeah, I'd say I'd put my rares on Radiant.
Okay, yeah. Well, yeah, just in terms of what a mixture of both player skill and the heroes that have been drafted.
Yeah, I think they have yeah. I don't know. I just think like Radiant are gonna be very, very aggressive. They have very aggressive players that I'm pretty sure are gonna be able to pressure Dire. Let's see, I mean I don't know, you know, in this league all the players are very, very strong. Some players are a bit weaker, but you know, in this game you have like really, like it's the top players in the Western scene anyway, so. But you have that Arise Magnus, that's quite nice. Then you're gonna have this Undying Phoenix dual offlane that is disgustingly strong. It's insanely strong.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, in a lot of these games, it seems to be that you guys love to fight. I mean, we're seeing a ridiculous amount of
Yeah.
kills fairly on. I mean, what's up with
We just fight. It's because we're bored of our
that?
scrims. And you know, we play, like, all the teams, they're gonna play scrims. Like, the schedule of the day is like,
Yeah.
if you wake up early, like, or you're just there at noon, you just play some FPL games to warm up, and then you go into scrims or officials. And then when it's like now, it's like 11, but at just, you know, around 10 p.m., you just start digging again. So you're bored of your scrims and your discipline, and then you just want to go all in. Yeah, now 1-47 is dead already. And then yeah, you pick aggressive lineups and you just go fight. You play Dota, you know, and just relax,
Right, we're
have
seeing a
fun.
bit more aggression here and dying. Crit's gonna walk
That's
in, hasn't
Bamboo for
skilled
you.
anything yet, but yeah.
So yeah, Undying is really strong versus Bristle early on in the
Yeah.
game. He destroys him completely. So we have a crit, Brilliant. Kuroki is gonna play Storm Spirit, so that's nice to see. Also, you get to see players on other roles, you know, support players on core roles, more than core players on support roles, unfortunately. But you get to see a lot of support players. You're gonna see Puppy solo mid, for example. That's something you want to see sometimes. It's quite fun.
Wow, indeed. And Shashlo as well. He's getting chased down here by the tree. Isn't going to be
Fucking
enough.
Bamboo, look at this. He's gonna chase him all the way.
He's going straight in, isn't he? He's got no fear at all. I mean, he's
He's
got
gonna be
another
in trouble,
decay
man.
available.
What is he doing? What? Classic Bamboo, man, creating space. But that's actually dumb. Like, he's not gonna get anything off. Now he's just dead. Yeah, that was really bad.
Was that worth it?
No, that wasn't worth it. That was super bad. That was awful. That was really awful. He
Oh,
probably
dear.
expected someone to follow up, but I mean, Lina was just farming the lane and Slaughter was getting zoned by the tree anyway, so. So, yeah, I don't know. W33 Phoenix now Undying supporting bottom. Yeah, I like that bottom lane for. Honestly, the bottom lane is really nice for Dire. They're gonna win bottom lane. And about top lane. Yeah, probably Radiant is gonna win it. And
Yeah.
mid is very even. I mean, not so even. Storm has the upper hand, but I think that a good Magnus could actually pressure the Storm a bit if you play around the skewer back. You know, you just scare him a bit, as in as if you try to skewer him under tower, and then you just get some less hits thanks to it. Like already, Arise is actually stomping.
Yeah, I was going to say, you're saying if you're a good Magnus, I guess Arise, you put him in that bracket at least. Bristleback goes down in the bottom lane as, well,
Yeah.
sexy Bambo. He does get away with it that time, man. Gets two kills.
They're so YOLO, man. Like, they're gonna destroy them. They're so aggressive. Like, Bamboo and yeah, they're very aggressive players. So, already Bristleback is, like, dying. He was only level 1, though. That's why. Like, it's gonna get better for him, but unfortunately, I know he falls.
Oh,
But
top
you know,
lane.
Undying Phoenix, all they want is levels. So, oh, yeah. Yeah, my predictions are right? Like, the Radiant is winning top lane and Dire is winning bottom lane. So far, so right. Let's see how it goes.
I mean, so Matt, obviously it's very high up in the league. When you get into a game with the players, do they kind of, let you make a lot of the big decisions because you are in that high position, or is that kind of irrelevant in the matches?
No, it's not very relevant. It's not like this. It's not because of your ranking. I don't think anyone cares about ranking. You know, all those players, like, they know that rankings doesn't mean so much. Obviously, if you're the top one, it means that you're a decent player. If you're the last one in the league, it means you might be a bit worse than others. But it's just, you know, MMR, this stuff, it doesn't mean anything. It's just the teams, the drafts, the plays, so much random stuff. But yeah, I mean, when I tag in those games, usually I'm captaining, and they listen to me just because they know I'm a captain in Dota, you know, like so it's usually a lot of players, they don't like to draft and they don't like to take command in game, and some players actually enjoy it. That's my case, so that's one of the reasons why they just trust you and let you do the draft and give them a hero and just play the game. You just have like natural leaders in game.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, you're gonna play a game with Fada, for example. He's very vocal, he talks a lot, then he's just gonna lead the game. Same goes for S4, I guess. Same goes for, in this game, it's probably S4 leading for the Radiant team, and probably, I'd say Bamboo or Arise leading for the Dire team.
Okay, I mean, in terms of obviously the way the games start, you do have that challenge mode where you get to pick a team. I mean, do you find in that mode, say you're picking, you'll always kind of pick your Alliance teammates first, or not necessarily?
Yeah, usually when you go into a challenge, it means that you're with some players, and you just wanna make sure you play with them. Like, let's say we're done screaming with Loda, Ake, whatever, and suddenly one of us just goes to do something else, and the others just wanna keep playing Dota. Then we're just gonna ask for a challenge in Face League. So you just pick your teammates usually, and if you're not really stacked, then you just go for SG. Now Fly is just feeding. Always want to fly, what are you doing, man? Oh, he's feeding.
Oh, yeah. Sexy Bambo.
They're dying bottom. What? Oh, this is awful. This is awful for Dire.
Slowest attack ever.
They don't want to give levels to the Skyros. They really don't. He's gonna crush those heroes completely.
40-37, having a bit of fun down here on the bottom lane, mid lane. Oh, our eyes baiting with the old RP. That's got the backup of Lina.
He's doing super well. He actually solo killed him. I missed that. He solo killed the Storm.
Yeah, he got a DZ and dived it, yeah.
Really nice. Arise is crushing Kuroki mid, actually. Quite nice. I know he's going to screw him back. Well done. Really well done. That's Dota right there. Alone.
I mean, so it's 6-6, but do you still fit? I mean, after the way the bottom lane went, mid lane, is there anyone that you're favoring at this stance, or are they both still very much in at the sides?
I'm not sure, because, yeah, it's hard to say. I think that Co-op, even with some kills and some farm, it's not gonna do much in this game. Like, you want levels. I don't know, on Radiant, S4 is not tanky at all, like, he's being raped. Co-op is not gonna have a high impact, and Storm is having a bad game. And on Dire, their playmaker is having a really bad game, which is the Slaughter. I don't know, I'd favor Dire a bit right now. I think Dire is getting the better trade, but Both the key heroes in both teams are actually really shut down in this game. Like the Bristle and the Slaughter, I think. And they're both getting like really, really bad farm.
Okay. I mean, the Slaughter is a hero. I mean, you guys, I've seen you pick it before with Alliance. I mean, where does he stand in the current meta? Is he just not great, or very in very niche kind of unique situations?
He's very strong. We lost our last two or three games with it, because people actually starting to figure us out, and then they play around it a bit. But it's kind of fine. It's also good that we lose those games now, because then we're also analyzing what do they do when they think they figured us out, and then we can also change it a bit. But I think Zora is a very strong hero, and I think he's still nice. His weakness, I guess, is that he's a weak laner. He's a good laner in a 2v1 situation, but 2v2, as you can see top, like, there's not much he can do. His damage output is very, very small. Like, the stun doesn't do any damage. It's 50 damage level 1. It's a joke. It's a right click, basically. So, like, he's really weak at laning, and they're abusing that in this game, for example. And then the Slaughter is really shut down, and then the Slaughter without a dagger is actually not very scary. Oh yeah, I think Slaughter is a really good hero, but you need to make sure he gets a good start.
Yeah, I mean, in terms of farm, he's not been having a good start at all. I mean, by the time he gets the Blink Dagger, is it at this point you feel it's just going to be a little bit too late to be that impactful?
I think, yeah, it depends. It depends on the timing. The thing is that with the Blink, he starts snowballing really hard. Like, the stun is honestly insanely good. It doesn't have a lot of damage, but in a teamfight situation, you get a... Like, you get a 2.5 second stun on 3 heroes every 8 seconds. honestly, it's super, super strong. So Stardar just comes back. Like, the game just starts when he gets the dagger, basically. It's as simple as that. But yeah, I don't know. No, I think it's going to be fine regardless. They have a lot of firepower. They don't need the Stardar to make plays. It's not like he's the only playmaker in the game. They have Undying Phoenix. Those heroes don't need anything to fight. And honestly, the Radiant team, they don't have much to... The thing with the Undying Phoenix, you know, it's the classic Cloud9 lane. That you, in fights, you need to kill both the egg and the tombstone. If you don't kill both, one of either the tomb or the egg is just gonna fuck the fight.
I mean, what do you prioritize in a situation like that when you have
really
got both
there? I don't know. You just disengage, honestly. You just get out.
Oh, nice RP there, Kuroki. Yeah, I mean, but you were saying earlier, he's not been having a great time. His farm's all right, I guess, 39 to 37, but the fact that the Magnus is finding these kills, and he got a good timing on the blink.
You know, Magnus got a blink, main at 8 against the Storm. You know, it's a very good lane for him. It's a bad lane, it's a very good timing for him, so... Arise is definitely getting, like, doing the better trade, and now they're going, is that... Yeah, I mean, yeah, you told me, you asked me, you kill the egg or the tombstone, honestly, you disengage. I think versus this... The best hero versus this lane is actually Centaur, in my opinion. Versus this pick, I mean, not the lane. When Cloud9 and those teams, they just abuse this egg tombstone, you pick Centaur. You bait the egg to get used or the tombstone, and you just stampede out. And then you take the fight. They have nothing. Those heroes, when they don't have egg or tombstone, they're actually useless. Like, they don't do so much. So you just disengage and go back in the fight.
Yeah, and also, what's something more general regarding Faceit Pro League? In a lot of the games I've casted, I cast competitive, and every competitive, you see your troll picked and banned. In FPL, that's not always the case. I mean, what's up with that? Is it just people respecting the fact that it's not a fun hero and they don't want to have that kind of stigma attached?
It's the same answer. Like, we've been playing Troll Wisp and whatever all day in scrims and in official matches, playing against and with, you know, we're bored. Like, we want to play other heroes, we want to have fun. So we just... They pick Undying, they pick Slaughter, they pick Lina. I guess Lina is not so fun. At least when I draft, I try to draft different stuff, like Legion. The game before, I was drafting some Elder Titan. I was just getting heroes that aren't used, you know. Also testing them. It's fine. It's very high level games, so... I mean... Testing stuff doesn't mean you're actually having, you know, playing a Clooney game. It's just, you have really good players against you, so you can actually get a good grip of knowing if the hero is good or not. So it's a win-win. You're having fun, and also you're trying, like, innovative stuff.
Well, Sexy Bambo could be in trouble. It pops the tombstone down. He's very,
nice
very
silence.
Dead.
Very nice silence, but now, like, tombstone plus Phoenix. Also, the combo is not only that you have to focus... That's a very bad egg, though. Like, it's not only that you focus either the egg or the tombstone. It's also that when you get those fire spirits, you actually can't kill the tombstone either. Nice cure.
That's true. I mean, the tombstone's still there. Look, the crit, he's reaching and he wants to take it down. He will go down himself, though. He loses his life.
That's alright, though. That's the right play. They don't have much versus the armor, actually. Whoa. Alright. Lina's down. Nice blink.
Looks like Dumpster might be in trouble. He's got the RP. And he's just still on turn dying.
Bamboo's gonna die again. Bamboo's just... He's just out of position, honestly. He's not playing really well. Now he's gonna go for the Storm. What? Yeah, that was... you see here, he didn't burn. I mean, he got the wave... What's it called? He got the shockwave from the back, so the Bristle had the pass, so he didn't get him. So it was not really well played from Arise, and this is Yu Storm coming back in the game. Now Kuro just having a decent game. He's actually top net worth. Yeah, that's Dota, whatever. But really good fight for Agent. They're doing quite well, and the Bristle cut off. Like, now they got a lot of XP and kills on Bristle and Storm. So that was actually, I think, dire, losing the early game now. This move was really bad for them.
I mean,
Bamboo's just dying.
Man, talking about Dota in general, you know, just the patch as a whole, the rubber band mechanics. Do you think, is this right? Is this how Dota should be? You know, we saw the early game, the laning stage. It was looking good for the Dire. You know, we saw some great laning from the Magnus. He got an early blink, but then one bad team fight. And then suddenly, if you look at the graphs, boom, 3k advantage in XP, and 3k in gold. Is that Dota working as intended?
No, I don't think so. I don't like it. At least, I really don't like it. The way it works, it's like... I was actually watching a game the other day, and one team was just crushing. Like, there was, I don't know, it was maybe Dire. They crushed it. They outplayed them. They outlaned them. They everything. and then they had like 50 or 20k gold or XP advantage. It was honestly just five players 10 times better, you know. They just, and then one bad fight. It was only one bad fight, and they got just a lucky RP or whatever. It wasn't, I think it was even the winning team just being over aggressive, and suddenly the game was even from one fight. Not even even. It's like, you know, you're playing support in the winning team. Like, as a support player, I know, like, the poorest like play hero in the game is always the support in the winning team. I mean, when the game gets a bit more even, you know, their support from one fight is gonna get his four staff plus his blink, for example, and then the game is actually not even at all, because like those support items, it actually means a lot. 2k or 4k difference on supports is one better positioning item, and then I don't know, you know, your shaker suddenly has a blink and you don't, and then the fight is completely different. Especially in high level games, the game is different. Sometimes you just can't fight because of those stuff, and I think that's very unbalanced, and it shouldn't be that way. It should be way more even. I mean, sure, for the action, for the opses and the casters and whatever, it's better, you know, to have those really back and forth action and team fights. But I don't think this is how Dota should be. I think it's actually very lame. But it's how it is, so you just, you know, you just play it and adapt, so it's fine. It will always be fine, but still, I think they should maybe even it a bit. It's a bit too much right now.
Well, we can see Overgrowth here onto Shashlo, but with the boost in move speed, Lina turning in with the Fire Dragon Slave, has the Lightstrike Array as well, Laguna Blade, a little bit too tanky and a little bit too speedy, is going to be able to get out of there. I mean, in the middle of that kind of the hard bonus point question, Mad, how do you fix it? What do you change? Is it, do you have to change how kind of the towers work in terms of armor? You make it harder? Do you have to change the bounties on the towers? Or is it just down to kind of, you know, the XP and gold gained when you kill a certain hero so far ahead?
XP and gold gain. Like, just what they did, just lower it a bit. Like the multipliers or whatever it's called. Just make them a bit smaller, that's all. And it should be fine. That, at least in my opinion. I think the towers, XP and bounty are okay. It's not unbalanced or anything. But just, like, the rest, just lower them a bit and it should be fine, I think.
And also, regarding if they do change the rubber band mechanics, obviously there's very set certain heroes that we see time and time again in competitive. Do you think just by changing the way that the game's played will instantly kind of shift the meta? Do you feel there are definitely certain heroes that need to be reworked?
Yeah, some heroes need a bit of nerf, I think. Mostly the troll. I think troll is a bit unbalanced right now, I'd say. I don't think Sniper is. I think Sniper is fine.
Okay.
I think Troll is very unbalanced. I think Sniper is okay. The thing with the Troll is that he's a very strong laner. He's kind of tanky. His late game is insane. He farms super fast. Like, everything about the hero is just insane. Sniper, at least, he's very, very squishy and very hard to protect. And if you just play well versus a Sniper, you should be able to, you know, just win the game or lower his impact. But a troll, you don't, you just ditch, you can't, there's nothing you can do.
No, okay. I mean, you don't feel that even the shrapnel needs a bit of a rework, you think, just because of the fact that he's still squishy? Sure. It's
no, it's, you know, fine. It is true, actually. It's not, shrapnel is really, really good. They could maybe nerf shrapnel a bit. That's true. The spell is actually too strong, I think. That you have a point. Maybe less movement speed slow or less damage. I'd say movement speed slow, but that's just me. I think, yeah, maybe rework the shrapnel, that's a good point. But I don't think Sniper is an unbalanced hero at all. I think Troll is. But, yeah, that's just me.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm gonna have to, I'm gonna have to leave you for a few minutes and then probably come back, unfortunately. Oh, I'm sorry about that. Yeah,
mad.
I'm sorry, that's why I wasn't tagging.
That's alright. Well, so hopefully seeing a bit mad. You're gonna come back to me,
definitely.
Mad.
Yeah, definitely.
We'll continue this chat.
Enjoy, have a good cast. Bye.
I'll see you in a bit, mad.
Yep.
Okay, guys, so back on with the game. Mid lane. They're going in for the push. Crit gets the amplified damage thrown down onto him. Tombstone will be thrown down by Sexy Bambo. Decay onto Bristleback. Keeping him back here. 10 to 16. Oh, there's your Blink Skewer. Bringing Carl back. But Carl. He's just going to walk it off. He doesn't give a hoop. Shashlo is going to start to slither away. The ult will just catch him. And Kuroki there with the shut off. Dumpster blinks forward. Gets the shockwave onto Skywrath. One for one at the moment. As we can see at the moment, 17 to 11. Favoring the Radiant side. They've had some very, very good fights, and obviously, as I was talking with Mad, the difference in gold and XP has been very evident. Even though from the off it looked a little bit stronger for the Dire. No, you know, the Dire with heroes like the Magnus, with that RP, they've got a lot of potential to bring this one back. It's going to be a tough one, though. So yeah, I kind of feel it's all down to Arise with those plays, with the RPs. Can he find himself involved? And can he find himself that massive five-man sucks? Come on. I mean, yeah, Arise Mag. You can never write off Arise Mag. Mid lane, Overgrowth on Sexy Bambo. Kill me! Okay, so, yep, anything you say, sir. Sexy Bambo on the Undying loses his life. 18 minutes in as well. Again, going back to what we were saying with Mad about the fact that seeing so many kills in these games. I mean, this is certainly not Chinese Dota. 29 kills, 18 minutes in. Kuroki's still on sprint. Not the best of starts, but he's turned it around and top of the net worth. Alongside Bristol and, of course, the Queen of Pain. Orchid, Sol Ring, 1k gold. Kuroki feeling very strong at this point. 1437, Thebam. The man behind the secret. The coach himself. Shashlo, 2.2k gold. He's got enough for that blink if he wants to go pick it up from the side shot. He might want to do so pretty soon as Carl, S4. And the Queen of Pain coming in. Bottom lane, sorry. Secret, Kuroki goes in. Finds a kill on Zelina. We'll be able to get himself out as well. No way that Sexy Bamba can stop the TP up. Ogre Club on top of the Vanguard now for the Bristleback. 2.5k gold as well. Mid lane, Dumpster. Arise, thinking about blinking Skirin. He's a little bit low on the mana. Going to get himself back out. He's got the Shadow Blade in his stash. Now on his persona. As he heads back to base. Shadow Blade Mag. This could be what they need to find these big RPs. Oh, hello, Shashlo. Trust going for a bit of fun. Ancient Seal and the Concussive and Arcane Bars coming out. In comes Kuroki. Kuro, no. Says the Slaughter as he gets taken down. 22-11. Blink Dagger now on the sky. 14-37. Was the gold he had when he was two-thirds of the way to the blink. 20 minutes in. Let's have a look at the graphs after that. Still 12k coming up in terms of XP. Coming up to the 10k point as well in terms of net worth. All right, level 11 has got the RP available. Can they find some kind of initiation? There is no Radiant Vision here. Has been taken down. There you go. There's your Shadow Blade. Don't stand near each other, boys. They've got the cover of the tier 1 tower. I'm going to back out. Arise. Come on. Where are these RPs that we need? Where are these RPs that we need? Zip. Top lane. Kuroki. He is the key to this puzzle. There's no secret about it. Slaughter goes down. Smoked up. Wanting to find something. They're not going to find it, though. The rest of the Dire, they're all down on the bottom lane in the bottom jungle. Radiant. Going to be left hanging dry here. TP's coming back now. Magnus with the Shadow Blade. Kuroki. Yo, hello, sir. You're going to need to get yourself out of here, I'm afraid, because Arise, he's hot on the truck, Kuroki. Go on, zip. You can sense it. Oh, he can't sense that. Oh, my goodness, RP. But the silence on to Lina is going to stop her from getting the stun. Kuroki is fine. He's helped to kill the Lina. He's going to turn on Arise. Measure yourself, Kuroki. You might get your face smashed in. Three heroes down on Dire, and now it might be more. Oh, he pops the sun, and, well, Mad wasn't pleased with the sun early. He's not going to be pleased with that one, because that one, again, putting Weehar in the center of it all, pays with his life. Double kill. Four Quap. Now for the tier 2. 25-12. Radiant having an absolute ball. It's only been on the up for them on the last kind of previous 5 minutes. This mid game has been fantastic here for the Radiant. Kuroki didn't have a great time in lane, but he's having a great time in game. Shashlo. Crip. He just guised up. Carl S4 himself on this Bristleback. Who would have thunk it? Shashlo. He wants to blink in. He's got the back of a true believer and kill me. Carl, he's a fairly tanky bastard, though. BKB pop. He's going to just try and walk this one off. Oh, the amplified damage, though. And there we go. He will go down. He's not going to be able to walk that off. In comes Kuroki with the drive-by. Says, Weeha. You better refresh yourself, my friend. You're down for 50 seconds. Storm Spirit, Kuroki looking for more. Gives a little bit of a tickle here to Sexy Bamboo with the bullet charges as well. Should be able to find it. That's going to be another kill. Arise has found himself a double the kill over the side. Hello, Lena. You can hide in the trees all you want, but this is a triple kill, my friend. For Kuroki. Kuroki Storm Spirit zips down to the low ground. Arise says... I don't know what Arise says. I was going to do an Arise impersonation, but I'm going to see him at DreamHack. I don't want him to smash my head in. 29-15. Shadowblade. Oh, 14-37. The silence! Fantastic! 14-37 there, with the reactions as soon as he came out from Invis. Words were certainly measured here today. Five heroes down on the dire. 23 minutes and a half in. 30-15.
Radiant now has a 14k gold advantage.
Here's Quantum. Hi then, Quantum.
Hey. Sorry, 14k XP, 12k gold.
It's looking pretty good for them. Hey, Quantum, I mean, I guess you spectate a lot of games. Are you seeing a lot of very even games in this league? I mean, you rarely see stomps, do you? Well, Kuroki. We are.
Well, yeah. I'm hoping they're even because I do my best to balance them.
Yes, so you created the whole kind of system. Is it the same as some kind of chess system, people say in chat?
It's like an ELO rating, and then the balancing is like kind of a weird... It just tries to minimize the difference in skill between the two teams. Obviously, everyone here is really skilled, but there's still like some differences.
Look at Rise! It's beautiful, but they get out! Oh, Bristol Bank doesn't think it's Lingoina Blade, but... Oh, hello! Quap, you want to turn around and bring that leader? Wow. So at the end of every game, does everyone... The winners all get the same amount. Is that how you've done it, or?
Yeah, winners and losers get the same. So. I just added a bonus though. If you end a winning streak, let's see if that happens anytime.
So that's actually going to give you extra points as well if you win a winning streak.
Yeah. So. Okay. Say like fucking mad.
A lot or quite a match. Not too many, I'd imagine. You're going to do, are you? Or will there be big bonuses?
I don't know, it's just small differences to encourage, like, ending win streaks and that kind of thing, because we don't want people to stomp too hard.
Well, that sounds like a pretty damn cool idea. I mean, obviously something like that, do you just add it, or do you, like, talk with the pros and see what their opinion is?
Yeah, I talked with them a bit, and they thought it was a cool idea, so I just added it. Something that I think was in a few of the older leagues. Same thing with something we might add is called Rapier, where... there's Storm Spirit going on there.
Oh, Kuroki. He's trying to find the kill on Sexy Bambo. Oh, he jukes it out. He's going to be able to fight. Oh, Laguna! Oh, Kuroki's just tanking it all up. He doesn't give a hoot. Denies himself as well. Doesn't find the kill, though. But he certainly buys a lot of time. In comes Shashlo with a blink onto Senpai. 14-37. He's going to be able to throw it out of the arcane bolt and back off. Queen of Pain going in. Tombstone is down. Crit's got the Overgrowth. Hosmorn in place. Shashlo will be able to find the crush there onto Treant. And Quap will be able to blink out. Mystic Flare coming down onto the head of the Treant Protector. Onto the Treant, but it's not hurting him. It's hurting the others. Still not enough to find any of the people on the side of the Dire. And the Dire cleaning up here. Three heroes down so far. Storm is back. He's going to be able to make himself apparent in this fight. There we go. Here comes Kuroki in the Kuroka cleanup. He's managed to find one. He's going to find two. Is it going to be three? Yes, it is. Is he going to go for four? Oh, Arise with a blink up to the high ground is going to be okay. 35-20. Triple kill there to Kuroki. Looking good for the Radiant. Quantum, are you the man who made this whole kind of chat system?
Yeah.
Can you make it, Quantum, so that it records how many games I cast? Just I've got a number. Is that possible?
It is. The game knows that you're casting, so certainly. That's a good idea.
Obviously, you guys at the moment, I think the only casters, is it just me and Valat that are in at the moment?
Yeah.
Yeah. So. That would be cool. Also, another request as well. For this stream, obviously, it's kind of cool with the Challenger ones for me to show it on screen, but I had to be careful because obviously the password comes up. Is there any way you can make, like... I don't like a page that I can go to as a streamer and I can capture it without having to worry of the password being displayed. But, you know, some kind of table system that shows the captains picking the teams.
That's another great idea. I can make a page for casters where you can select the match and get like nicely formatted things for the stream, I guess.
That would be very nice. And well, True Believer's about to get formatted. We'll have the Yule Scepter, throws himself up, buys him some time on Kuroki. He doesn't want to actually go for it. The format is cancelled and True Believer's going to be okay. And they're going to back up Carl as for. Thinking about leading this one in Senpai. 14:37 with a concussive bolt onto Lina. They do throw down the tombstone onto the high ground. And that's going to mean it's going to be two times that they're going to have to think before finding this secret. Kuroki pops the BKB on the old Phoenix. Scares it out of him. 35-20. Yeah, if you could do that as kind of like an overlay, that would be pretty damn awesome indeed.
Yeah. And I think OBS can take like data from websites too.
That's
so
true, with the CLR browser. Yes. Yeah, if you could do that as well. Yeah, if we could set up like a CLR browser plugin interaction, which I think, you just have to make it as a HTML, whatever it is, I don't know, computers, and then I can put it in. That would be cool. What else? Oh, is there any way as well, if you could do that, is there any way that obviously the system... Oh, hang on, Kuroki is going to go for a kill here. Find Shashlo, Orc and a Malevolence and the right clicks. That's going to be enough to take down your position once Lardar. Oh, Arise from the Invis, pops the RP. Lightstrike Array is going to be off point, though. Kuro's just going to TP out and it gets away with it. My goodness. Okay, anyway.
Selfish.
Wow. Unfortunate play there. And off the back of that as well, Radiant, they're going to be able to get themselves the old Roshan as well here. And the Dire can't do a single thing to stop that from happening. There we go. Roshan, we're going to... And yes, is there any way... I don't know if you've looked at the stream at all, but you see how I do kind of the player thing where it says who's on who? Obviously, on the FPL client, it knows who's playing what hero. Can you think of any way that I can do it so it kind of picks that up automatically and then I can overlay it on the stream so it shows who's who?
Yeah, for sure. We can do that. Although it should be easier when we get the ticket. It'll change their names back to their pro names.
Yeah. So yeah, because when it's ticketed, that means that it will always use the official player info, right? Is that what happens?
Yeah, it forces them. And everyone will be a stand-in, unfortunately, which is kind of annoying. Because the teams are just like...
That is going to be a little... Well, I don't know. It's just not great. But I guess there's no way, unless Valve themselves agree to change a setting in regards to that, that you can avoid that.
Yeah, maybe if everyone is a stand-in, don't show stand-in.
Because literally everyone will... Unless sometimes, well, they pick teams, don't they, for a bit of fun, the players. They like to sometimes put their official team in.
They've got MB top right. I don't know what that is, but...
MB, yeah. A bit of Tom and Jerry there as well, yeah. Not too sure.
Yeah.
Not too sure.
The cool logo.
But so you reckon the ticket might be out tomorrow?
Well, I mean, hopefully. I think they're, weekend right now, and I think they only deploy patches on weekdays, so... A ticket's pretty easy for them to add, so I'm hoping that they do it tomorrow. Kind of optimistic, to be honest.
And the ticket's going to be free, right?
Yeah, free ticket to spectate. Actually, free for everything.
There's not going to be a purchasable with items or anything, or?
Not right now. I don't know what they have planned. They might add something like that later, but for now, we don't have anything like that. It's just a spectate ticket.
Okay, that's cool. And top lane Kuroki tries going on a rise, but Arise pops the Shadow Blade. We'll be able to walk out. But, I mean, yeah, free ticket for this. I mean, that's going to be an easy front page, isn't it, for Face It? People are going to love that.
Yeah, hopefully, yeah. People are complaining that we don't have it already, which... We came up with a way to spectate in-game from the pro.faces.com site, which is cool, but it's not quite the same. Once we have a ticket, like all the sites that track league games will start tracking our matches and we'll get cool like stats pages and stuff. So
yeah,
there's
actually,
a lot of stuff that's been built around the leagues already, so we'll have that.
At the moment, are there lots of numbers being recorded behind the scenes in terms of stats regarding these games?
Yeah, we record the match data and everything, and the replay. So, I'm not displaying it anywhere, but maybe.
Because, it would be interesting to see, will we ever be able to see stats like, a player's win rate when partnered up with certain other players?
Yeah, the reason why I haven't really done that is because there's so many sites that do that already for leagues. So if you look at like TI, it'll tell you all the info. And they automatically pick up new leagues that come out. So once we get a ticket, we'll get like all of those stats, like all the stats we could ever want, including like heroes picked, win loss, all that kind of thing.
Okay, okay.
In terms of wins and losses, you have the leaderboard, but...
Yes. Yeah, that is true. Someone's asking in chat, can I ask you about the TeamSpeak bots? I don't know what that means. Do you know what that means?
Oh, yeah. So the thing that we want to do is put two bots in Dota TV caster slots. So one for Radiant, one for Dire, so that we can stream the team audio.
Oh, that's genius. Yeah.
Yeah. So the cool thing is no one has ever actually made... one guy did, but he hasn't... Well, he... Okay. Let me make this a little more clear. So only one guy has ever made a bot that can actually connect to the game and move characters around and like type in chat and that kind of thing. And he released his code a couple weeks ago. Some parts of it are missing that we're filling in now, but that means that in the next, probably by the end of today, we'll have figured out how to actually connect a bot to the game.
Okay.
There's a fight here.
Yeah, Lindsay, there is. RP onto Quap. This time, Lightstrike Array misses again. Doesn't matter. Laguna Blade will be there to rectify the misplay of the Lightstrike. So all the bot needs to do is what? Needs to get itself in the game and then connect to TeamSpeak and then simply broadcast what it's hearing from the TeamSpeak onto the in-game audio. I guess, well, in terms of doing anything in-game, it doesn't need to do anything, does it?
Yeah, no, it doesn't need to do anything but connect and listen.
Yeah.
I mean, we might have it do more like type in the chat sometimes, but...
Nope, Dumpster Player Eyes getting silenced up through the invis. He'll go down. That's the first hero to fall. Second hero to fall now on the side of the Dire. Lina going down as well. Girl, kill me, sexy Bambo. He'll lose his life. There is going to be a supernova, but they're just going to turn and try and fight this. Can they pop it? They doesn't look like they'll be able to. No, Weeha isn't going to be able to get out. They've already lost three heroes here on the side of the Dire. And now they're looking at the tier threes, and they might be able to get some racks here. Fortification will come out, but three heroes down. No buybacks available at all. I mean, so in regards to the TeamSpeak thing, I mean, at the moment, when I've been kind of flicking into TeamSpeak channels to listen, I always kind of feel kind of bad, because I don't know if the players are going to be like, oh, you know, why is he listening in? But they're cool with that, from what you gather.
Yeah, they don't care at all. Waga was streaming with where he would cast, but he'd just have the teams on in the background always.
Okay. Oh, that's cool.
And they didn't seem to care, so.
Yeah, that's good to know. People absolutely love that. They're starting to print their own money here. They're doing everything right. They're doing everything that people have wanted from a pro league. So, no, that's.
Yeah, we're trying hard, man.
Yes, a denial before the Laguna. Kuroki there with the BM. Fantastic. But, So the plan is, you get the two bots. So you have these two separate channels in game so people can listen to what the teams are saying. And then I guess there'll also just be the caster slot that someone like me can cast in. Is there the plan to add more casters, or will casting for FPL always be kind of a controlled thing, do you think?
Anyone's free to stream and cast from Dota TV.
That's true. Yeah.
Whenever they want. In terms of like official casters, yeah. I think some people from Good Studio will be casting as well. Kuroki, easy pickoff there.
Yeah, Kuroki's finding pickoffs and a half. 21-6. He's having a great game. RP will catch himself and the Quap. They do find the refresh RP, and they are going to be able to hopefully find the Queen of Pain for themselves. No. Refresher RP, not enough. Getting away here, Carl. He's going to go on Weeha. Weeha's trying to run. Pots the BKB. That's not going to help you against the physical damage here coming from Carl. That's going to be a death. Shaxlow blinking in. Not in a great position. He'll go down as well. There's a double kill here for the Bristleback. Four heroes to fall on the Dire. GG, well played, is indeed called. As long as it's not a fake GG, that looks like that is going to be the game. Well and truly over. GG, there's the Radiant, who do take that victory. What was I going to say? Quantum. What else could you implement that would be cool? What else could you could do? Are you going to? What any other plans, Quantum? Tell me.
Well, hang on.